The list of top 10 whiskey collections in the world is one you can't necessarily find here in Oklahoma City.
That is, unless you get a special invite from the owner who can't keep his passion for scotch corked, as we learned in our Red Dirt Diaries.
Behind this bookshelf, a secret room with walls of whiskey.
Tried my first single malt, fell in love with it.
That could have easily been wine. For OKC's Dwayne Poore.
A medical thing. I have an inner ear thing called Meniere's syndrome, and I could no longer have the tannins in red wines, and that's all I drank was Cabernet Sauvignon.
The complexity of rare scotches and bourbons filled the void, and eventually this room, which houses less than half of Poore's multi-million dollar whiskey collection.
Still not about the money. It's about something, passion for me, finding something that I enjoy doing, enjoy sharing with other people.
That included me and our Brian Mueller, a whiskey connoisseur himself. But both of us got really nervous each time Poore put a bottle so close to the edge of a table. Turns out all this lucrative liquid is insured.
Most I've paid for a bottle of whiskey is $30,000.
According to Poore, it's now worth double. Here's another find, a gold-veined bottle of Old Weller with its original price tag.
These are selling them currently for between $800 and $1,000 on the secondary market. And this was purchased in Oklahoma in the 80s for $14.49. Whiskey in general was number one in a survey done in 2018. It had increased in value, if you bought it in 08 to 2018, 582%.
The cardiovascular perfusionist now partners with investors, playing the market of single malts. Dwayne Poore shares his love through Stag, the whiskey bar he owns in Deep Deuce. For him, whiskey is a joy that shouldn't be kept bottled up.
It just builds some long-term relationships and friendships that just can't be beat.
He goes all over the world for this stuff, and he told us the other day that his wife got a little angry the first time he was collecting these.
Sure.
You know, how much he was spending on whiskey.
But then she saw how much it's worth now.
Yeah, and he said, well, here's what it's worth now. She's like, you're good.
Okay.
You're fine. Yeah.
Florida, the cost of some of those, though.
Oh, my gosh. So unreal. But
a lot of folks can't hang on to it that long because we just drink it.
Well, he does, too. He has one to enjoy, then he has one to hold on to for a while.
What a neat hobby, though.
That'd be hard to open up a really expensive one.
Oh, gosh, yes.
You'll never have one of those in your house.
No.
I mean, I'll just take a sip of it.
I'm afraid I'm going to break it, right?
Yeah, right? You were worried you were going to knock
one of those up. Earthquake insurance, by the way.
I love the fact that Brian went with you for no reason except to try to drink.
He's a whiskey guy. I'm like, I think you'll like this. You want to come. So.
No part of the story, no contribution at all, just to drink for Brian. All right.
He was there to enjoy.
He was there for moral support. All right, and to drive you home.